When you think about cybersecurity jobs, there's a wide range of technology, people, and process jobs. Right? When I look at it, one of my favorite people who've moved across is a librarian. Because one of the things we have to do is manage large document stores. And so we look for people who have a skill set that can translate, and rather than thinking of it as an entry-level job, it's really an insertion-level job. Right? How do you insert yourself into a job that's about cybersecurity, but it takes skills from other disciplines as well?
Now, Kelly, you've found someone who has a set of skills that we would also think might be, in the current world, somewhat antiquated, and yet you've taken a repo man.
Yeah, so in one of my previous roles, I had a repo man who actually came over and was an amazing pen tester. And the skills are very similar. It's just, he was a repo man.
So and a what kind of tester?
A penetration tester.
Okay, thank you.
So a penetration tester is very similar to a repo man. It's someone that goes in and looks at a computer system. They have that security mindset. They look for different types of vulnerabilities. They look for different ways to penetrate the network and exploit it. So a repo man actually has to do that as well, just in a more analog world. Mm-hmm. This is just a digital version of that type of job.
And how long did it take for the transition to take hold?
He had computer skill sets already, so it was just a simple migration into that, and he developed some of those penetration skills, testing skills, over a matter of 6 months to a year. Mm-hmm.
Now, Joe, you may work in one of the most vulnerable sectors of the economy. We hear a lot of the stories about whether or not our grid is safe and what kind of skill set you need to protect the electricity grid in the event of just, simple malfunctions, technologically speaking, to things that are more sinister in nature. So is there a different skill set that's required among your employees when you're talking about critical infrastructure versus core technology?
A lot of the cybersecurity skills are portable, transferable across companies and industries. We have, obviously, in our sector, a strong compliance component, both from institutions like the Nuclear Regulatory Commission or the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission, that put some twist to what we're looking for. But obviously, for entry levels, we're not expecting those resources to be familiar with those regulations. We train them. We look for skills that are typically foundational. So we're one of those companies that like to get bachelors. But we will also look for associates with equivalent work experience. And we don't, we have people who come from all different backgrounds. We also tend to highlight a lot of the technical skills, but as someone just mentioned, there are a lot of cybersecurity roles that are not technical per se necessarily. It could be somebody who validates supply chain partners, looks for third-party risks, auditors type of skills, and all of those are transferable across industries in my view.